VST plugins can be used in several DAWs like Ableton, FL Studio, your Cubase, and a lot more. Pro Tools, on the other hand, does not support VST plugins officially. Pro Tools supports AX plugins, but there is a way around for using VST plugins in Pro Tools, and that can be done using Wrapper plugins. Wrapper plugins are basically AX plugins that you can load into Pro Tools, and within these Wrapper plugins, you can load VST plugins and use them. There are several Wrapper plugins like BlueCut Audio Patchworks, NewGen Sigmod, DDMF Meta plugin. Today, I'm going to use DDMF Meta plugin and show you how you can use it to load VST plugins into Pro Tools. So let's move over to the computer and get started. I'm here in the Pro Tools session window now, and I have inserted an audio track. This is the track. What I'm going to do next is I'm going to insert the DDMF Meta plugin into this track, and this is where the plugin is. So this is the DDMF Meta plugin. This is an AAX plugin. What I'm going to do next, I'm going to load a VST plugin from the list on the left that is here. These are all VST plugins that are installed in my computer. Your computer list might be different. You can scan for plugins from here, scan for new plugins or updated VST plugins in your computer. So I'm going to load the Color EQ64 DDMF. This is a VST plugin by DDMF. It's a freeware. You can also install it. This is not a sponsored video by any ways. I'm just using these plugins because I just use them regularly as well. So the process is just drag and drop it. The next thing I need to do is I need to route this plugin input to the output. Otherwise, if I switch over and play this track, you will not hear anything. So I'm going to route these inputs to the outputs. Done. You can also change the volume levels for input and outputs from here. Okay, next I'm going to double click and open the plugin. Now you can see here is the interface. This is a VST plugin that has been loaded into your Pro Tools. Now let's use it. So I have inserted a high pass filter, and let's cut the frequencies, let's say up to 2260, and let's play back the track now. As you can see, the plugin is now working. Now you know how you can use VST plugins within Pro Tools, but do you know how to automate plugins in Pro Tools? Watch the next video and find out.